Greetings fellow nerds. In this video we're going to make sodium oxalate, a useful chemical for redox titrations where we measure the concentrations of oxidants like hydrogen peroxide. I intend to use potassium permanganate as my titrant for hydrogen peroxide, but potassium permanganate is not very reliable due to variable purity. So another highly reliable standard chemical, called the primary standard or analytical standard, is used to standardize it. Sodium oxalate is an excellent primary standard for the amateur since it's easy to make and purify. So let's do that. First, we start with 120 grams of oxalic acid dihydrate. To this, we add 300 milliliters of water. Now, stir and heat the mixture until completely dissolved. Oxalic acid has dramatically improved solubility at higher temperatures, which is why we have to heat this up. Once it's completely dissolved, we slowly add a solution consisting of 80 grams of sodium hydroxide in 200 milliliters of water. Be careful as the solution will boil since it's already very hot. The reaction of an acid and base tends to generate even more heat. You can substitute equimolar sodium bicarbonate if you want, but the bubbling from the carbon dioxide tends to make this even harder to control. So I'm using sodium hydroxide. What's happening is the sodium hydroxide is reacting with the oxalic acid to make sodium oxalate. Sodium oxalate has low solubility in water, even in hot water, so it instantly precipitates out. This makes sodium oxalate very easy to prepare and purify for the amateur chemist. Most of the impurities in the oxalic acid and the sodium hydroxide would remain in solution. Now you might be wondering why we're bothering to make sodium oxalate as a standard for redox titrations when oxalic acid is also redox active. The problem with oxalic acid is that it can be somewhat variable in its hydration level. It's not always exactly two water molecules per oxalic acid molecule, and can vary by several percent. While this is inconsequential for most chemical reactions, this is unacceptable for analytical chemistry. Heating it up to remove all water is difficult as it tends to decompose. Using other chemicals like I showed for azeotropic drying introduces other contaminants, which again makes it unsuitable for analytical chemistry. Sodium oxalate on the other hand is easy to make and purify, drying it is also easy, and it doesn't have water crystallization to throw off weight measurements. So overall it's a better analytical standard than oxalic acid. Okay, once all the sodium is added, turn off the heating and let the mixture cool back down to room temperature. Keep stirring it though as you don't want to aggregate. Now when it's cool, vacuum filter the mixture. Wash down the product with water to remove any remaining impurities. Scoop it out and heat it in oven or on the hot plate at 200 degrees Celsius. Here it is after heated drying. Grind it up into a powder by hand or using a blender. Then heat it again to 200 Celsius for about an hour or so to drive off all the remaining water. For analytical use, it's important that it's dry. And there we have it, sodium oxalate.
Okay, so why am I bothering to spend a whole separate video to make this? In an upcoming video, I'm going to delve into analytical chemistry. And in particular, I'm going to titrate hydrogen peroxide using potassium permanganate to determine its exact concentration. But I need to first calibrate or standardize the potassium permanganate solution since my source of potassium permanganate isn't pure and I'm not certain if what I weigh is exactly the amount that will react. Sodium oxalate is a great primary standard to standardize potassium permanganate against, as the chemistry is very simple and the sodium oxalate is highly stable. So there is no worry about decaying in storage, unlike say sodium metabisulfate, which could theoretically be a redox standard, but is unstable in practice and decays in storage. So we use sodium oxalate. I know it seems trivial for us to spend a video doing just a precipitation reaction, but a high quality primary standard is critical for performing analytical chemistry. And the simplicity of making it is a feature that benefits us in reducing errors and uncertainties later on. All of this will make much more sense in my upcoming video where I use potassium permanganate to titrate hydrogen peroxide oxygen bleach and determine its purity. So subscribe for that one and thanks for watching.
Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.